Hey guys, my name is Joy. I'm a year 4 journalism and finance student at the University of Hong Kong. In case you guys haven't heard, I am still digesting news that I recently won the District 89 Table Topics contest for this year. Honestly, I still can't believe the fact that I won. I'm still trying to digest this. But today, to celebrate this achievement, I thought I'd make a video sharing my experiences preparing for this contest. I was initially actually competing to win the international championships, and I joined the Table Topics contest on the side. Oh, you know, I have a Thursday evening. What's the harm? Let's give it a try. And I did not think I'd make it this far. But to all those out there that think, oh, I'm not made for Table Topics, or maybe impromptu speech isn't my thing, you just gotta give it a try and you never know where you'll make it in the future. So in this video, I'm gonna talk about how I prepared for this contest, and I specifically divided this video into timestamps so that you get to know how I spent the earlier parts of my time at Toastmasters, say when I first joined Toastmasters or even few months before the contest, and how I prepared for Table Topics. And the next part of the video is gonna be about the few days before the contest or even the few hours before the contest and how I prepared for the contest in that time. So I will put timestamps in this video in case you guys want to skip to any part. But let's get started with preparing for the contest few months earlier, or even whether you're just starting out as a Toastmaster. Okay guys, let's get started with the most important part about Table Topics. So what is the reason we actually have Table Topics contests? That is to make your speech memorable. So when you come in as a Toastmaster, you'll notice that we have Toastmasters meetings on a variety of subjects. But over time, you'll boil it down to a few central themes. You get asked questions about family, friendships, relationships, finance, health, and many major topics that get discussed very often. And the key to nailing Table Topics is to have some kind of insight or great story in each of these core fields, so that whenever you go up to the contest, no matter whatever question they throw at you, whether it's a phrase, a word, or an actual question, you're still able to ace it. So during this contest, our topic was actually money is not an object. So I can tell you that I'm a finance student and I've studied finance for almost 4 years now. And I disagree with this statement strongly, because I do believe money is an object. The biggest debate in finance has always been, oh, what's the best way to invest? Do we go into fixed income? Do we go into equity? Is it derivatives? Well, after 4 years of finance, I can tell you it's none of them. It's the importance of investing in yourself. Because if you run after money in your life, you're not going to reach happiness, because after a certain level, money doesn't exactly translate to more happiness. And it's also, if you run after so much money and a thief someday comes and steals that money, it's gone. But if you take the time to invest in yourself, your leadership, your communication skills, or whatever skills you need to succeed in the workforce in the future, nobody can steal that away from you. And that is what I call the best form of investment. That's why everybody needs to realize that money is an object, in fact, and trust the finance student in the room. So that's kind of how I shared my speech during the final Table Topics contest for the district level. And I had a solid opinion about finance and the best investment strategy. And I tackled that question with my experience, with things that I've read, accumulated from videos, podcasts, movies. And as you spend more time in Toastmasters, try and identify these central themes: family, friendships, relationships, finance, health, environment, and think about insights in these topics, great stories that relate to these topics that you can easily grab when you have Table Topics contests and nail your contest. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna talk about is not running away from hard Table Topics. So let me just say, I've been in Toastmasters since August 2017. So that's almost 3 years now. And I have come across some pretty crazy Table Topics questions. The hardest question for me has always been, and this is even before Toastmasters, is what came first, the chicken or the egg? And to be honest, if anybody were to ask me this question, like some random person on the street, I would just be like, I'm a vegetarian, y'all. I don't care. But this doesn't work in table topics because you have to speak for about 2 minutes. So I too took some time to answer difficult questions like whether the chicken or the egg came first. And I concluded maybe the fact that I don't care has a lesson behind it. The fact that maybe our world has lazy people like me that people shouldn't learn from, but rather there are hardworking people willing to answer difficult questions that don't give up, and we need to learn from those people, not from me. For example, the COVID-19 crisis. The vaccine is not an easy question, and some people could just give up on it, but there are perseverant people out there working hard and determined that we will find a solution to this COVID-19 case. And people should learn from great ones like them and not lazy ones like me. I think this would be a memorable life lesson and hopefully something the judges would remember, and probably my best bet if I ever got asked whether the chicken or the egg came first. Okay, let's move on to the next tip, which is pretty self-explanatory. To always be open to trying out table topics, regardless of whether it's at your own club or at another club. So I notice whenever you visit other Toastmasters clubs, club culture can change. It can vary, and some clubs are more general with their questions, some clubs are more specific, and you have no idea who decides on the question for the contest. So you need to get as much experience as you can. So go out, visit other Toastmasters clubs, whether that means visiting them physically or now even through online meetings. But try out questions wherever you go, and you'll get better at table topics in the long term. Okay, so let's move on to the second part of today's session, which is how you get ready for the contest a few days or a few hours before the contest. So since this year we had an online contest, I think the most important tip is to get comfortable with speaking to the camera. So I myself am not very used to this. I watch many YouTubers and I admire them for having this skill. However, it took time for me to get used to this little guy right here. Therefore, I have some tips for you guys. Like, one of the things that has really helped me is putting a teddy bear behind the camera. So behind the camera lens, and it feels like I'm talking to this teddy bear while I'm doing my speech, and it helps me interact with the camera more as if there's really an audience there, although it's just a blank wall, sad wall. Another thing you can do is actually stick a photo next to your camera lens, maybe a photo of family members, friends, and it look like you're interacting with them while you're doing your speech. I believe that helps me a lot, but ultimately it comes down to getting used to looking at the camera, because oftentimes when we deliver a speech, we expect a great audience around us, and we're so used to looking at the audience, interacting with the audience, but that doesn't happen with online contests, and it's just a matter of getting used to it. The next tip I have is the importance of warming yourself up with questions, whether this is a few days before the contest or even a few hours. I personally like to do this both few days before the contest and few hours. Sometimes I'll have friends call me up on the phone, like, ask me the hardest question you can think of and try and deliver a table topic speech. And if it really is that hard, I'll see how long I can go for these topics before stopping or perhaps even giving up. I think this is a great way to prepare yourself for the contest, specifically because you're looking at the camera like you're, you know, having the contest going on, and you can ask your friends to read out the table topics contest question like you would have it read out at the actual contest. Like, oh, Joy Pomnani, money is not an object. Money is not an object, Joy Pomnani. And then you go on delivering your speech like it's an actual contest and see how long you can last and whether or not you're really prepared for this contest, or what themes are you specifically weak at that you can focus on in the couple of few hours or few days so that you can nail this contest. So my final tip for preparing for the table topics contest, and I highly suggest you do this few hours or even like 30 minutes before the contest, is to tackle being nervous. So there's this quote by Mark Twain: public speakers are either nervous or liars. So if you're not nervous when you go up on stage, you're probably not normal, because we're all nervous regardless of whether we're looking at a camera or a huge crowd of people. Now, there are different ways to tackle being nervous. Some people like to go with deep breaths. Some people prefer power posing. There's a TEDx talk on power posing, and it's on YouTube, very famous, and many of my friends use it. I like to dance. I've heard that dancing reduces stress hormones, and it makes me feel relaxed. As I notice myself, I also dance in front of a mirror, and that makes me comfortable with the stage that I'm using. Obviously, I can't do this if this contest were a physical contest, and like I can't just borrow the stage to myself and start dancing there. But before an online contest, the stage is all mine and nobody's there to judge me, so I believe it's a great way to warm up. But you can pick your own way for warming up for these contests. So guys, I hope this video helped you. In the description below, I'll also include some crazy table topics questions that I've received in the past and spent quite a bit of time thinking about, like, the ideal answer to these questions, or perhaps a way I could have improved my answer when I was delivering it on stage, or maybe I heard this from someone else doing a table topic. To all our upcoming contestants in table topics, I wish you all the best. Let me just tell you, we're all nervous, okay? If you're not nervous, then you're not normal, because we are all nervous. But it's just a matter of overcoming this fear, getting used to it, practicing with your camera when it's an online contest, or if it's like a physical contest with your audience, and you will ultimately get better at it and ace this contest. I wish you guys all the best and hope to see you in a future video. Thank you.